So we're in the book of Jeremiah, chapter 33, and we are at verse 16. Let me go back to 15. Verse 15, let me read from there. In those days and at that time will I cause the branch of righteousness to grow up unto David, and he shall execute judgment and righteousness in the land. This is speaking about the son of David, which is Yahushua HaMashiach, Jesus Christ. He's the son of David. This is the branch that grows up unto David. Verse 16. In those days shall Judah be saved. Oh my goodness. So we're talking about the next set of people that are captive. So it has to be after Jesus comes, he lives his life, he died for all the sins of mankind, and rose from the dead. These prophecies have to be after the Son of David came on the scene. Listen carefully to these words. In those days shall Judah be saved, and Jerusalem shall dwell safely. Do you remember in the book of Acts chapter 2, on the day of Pentecost, when the Holy Ghost came, the people were inquiring, "What is this?" And the Apostle Peter said, "This is that which was spoken by the prophet Joel." And he started to say, in the last days, this is after the resurrection, in the last days, it shall come to pass, says the Lord, I will pour out my spirit upon all flesh. Your sons, your daughters shall prophesy. Your young men shall see visions. Your old men shall dream dreams. In my servants and my handmaids in those days will I pour out my spirit, the anointing to be minister, men and women, sons and daughters, my servants and handmaids, and they shall prophesy. That means preach. Men and women in the last days are going to preach. This is the Apostle Peter quoting the prophecy in Joel chapter 2 from verse 28 to 32. Men and women in the last days shall preach. Do not accept the dogma that some of these preachers are saying that men, only men preach. Men and women shall preach, they shall prophesy. The deacon Philip, the evangelist that preached in Samaria and to the Ethiopian, he had four daughters that were preachers. They were prophets. Four daughters were prophetesses. All right. And in the last days, Joel said in verse 32, and it was quoted by Peter, the Apostle Peter, on the day of Pentecost, and in those days, the last days, there shall be deliverance in Jerusalem. Those that call on the name of the Lord shall be saved. For in Mount Zion and in Jerusalem shall be deliverance, as the Lord hath said, and in the remnant whom the Lord shall call. Jeremiah picks up that same thing hundreds of years before it happened on the day of Pentecost, and 2,500 years before us. And this is yet to happen. This prophecy is yet to happen. Listen. In those days shall Judah be saved, and Jerusalem shall dwell safely. And this is the name wherewith she shall be called, Yahuwah, the Lord, our righteousness. Verse 17, watch this now. For thus saith Yahuwah, the Lord, David, King David, shall never want a man to sit upon the throne of the house of Israel. That means, right now, a son of David is sitting on the throne, or else this prophet is lying, and that's not possible. Where is this son of David sitting on the throne? Well, he's not in Jerusalem, that's for sure. Have you taken a look in the last few years? Israel is not even there, hallelujah. Gentiles are there. There's no king in Jerusalem, so where is the son of David? He's in heaven, sitting on the throne. And that's where the New Jerusalem is coming from, folks. Are you hearing me? The scripture says, David shall never want a man to sit upon the throne of the house of Israel. So the Holy Ghost comes through him to us. Because the Apostle Peter prophesied and said, he, this Messiah, the King of Israel, the King of the Judeans, who rose from the dead, he poured out this Holy Spirit that you now see and hear. Are you hearing me? That's when they asked Peter, well, what shall we do then to be saved? Because we condemned him to death. Yes, you did. So here's what you need to do right now. This you found in verse 37, and now I'm going to quote verse 38. Right? This is Acts chapter 2. Listen now. Here's what you do. If you're sorry for your sins, repent over your sins. And be baptized, every one of you, in the name of Yahushua HaMashiach, Jesus Christ, for the remission of sins. So if you want your sins to be removed, you repent and be baptized in the name of Jesus Christ, not a no-name brand. You have to call on his name. Joel said, and Peter quoted, whosoever shall call on the name of Yahuwah, the Lord, shall be saved. Not his title, his name. Singular name. You got to call on the name of the Lord. The Son of David has a name. His name is Yahusha, Jesus the Christ. So repent and be baptized, every one of you. How many of you? Everyone. From when? From then till now. Everyone. Because even in his name shall the Gentiles trust. That's in Isaiah chapter 65. The Gentiles can call upon the Lord and his name. I'll get to that in a minute. Let's just continue with Acts chapter 2 verse 38. Repent and be baptized, every one of you, in the name of Jesus Christ, for the remission of sins, and you shall receive the gift of the Holy Ghost. For the promise is unto you and to your children and to all that are afar off, Gentiles, even as many as the Lord our God shall call. Let's get back to Jeremiah. I've got a few minutes and I'm closing up with this. Watch this now. Verse 18, I'm going to read verse 17 and 18 again. For thus saith Yahuwah the Lord, David shall never want a man to sit upon the throne of the house of Israel. Neither shall the priests, the Levites, want a man before me to offer burnt offerings and to kindle meat offerings and to do sacrifice continually. These are the ancient children of Israel. Their descendants will be performing that to this day. When we preach the gospel, this is what we're doing. Watch this. And the word of the Lord came unto Jeremiah, saying, thus saith the Lord, if ye can break my covenant of the day and my covenant of the night, that there should not be day and night in their season, then may also my covenant be broken with David my servant, that he should not have a son to reign upon his throne. And you can break my covenant with the Levites, the priests, my ministers. Oh my goodness. So their descendants are going to be around till this day. Hello? We're talking black history. Watch this. As the host of heaven cannot be numbered, neither the sand of the sea measured. This is verse 22. So will I multiply the seed of David, my servant, and the Levites that minister unto me. We are the children of David and of Aaron the priest and the sons of Levi. That's who we are. Here's your black history. That's our true identity. We're not black. We're of the kingdom of Judah. We are Judeans. This is Judean history here. This is Bible, folks. Listen to verse 23. Moreover, the word of Yahuwah, the Lord, came to Jeremiah saying, consider thou not what this people have spoken, saying, the two families which Yahuwah, the Lord, hath chosen, he hath even cast them off. Slavery. All right? Thus they have despised my people, calling us derogatory names, not even calling us by who we are. Whoa! Here it is. They've despised my people. Who's the they? Gentiles. That they should be no more a nation before them, before the Gentiles. Verse 25 and 26, thus saith Yahuwah, if my covenant be not with day and night, and if I have not appointed the ordinances of heaven and earth, then will I cast away the seed of Jacob and David my servant, so that I will not take any of his seed to be rulers over the seed of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. For I will cause their captivity, their slavery, these, the sons of the slaves, the daughters of the slaves, I will cause their captivity to return and have mercy on them. This is a prophecy unto people who were enslaved. Before slavery, they were the children of Israel and of Judah. And he says, after slavery, he's going to cause their captivity to return. That's our destiny as a nation. We are not black. We are Israel. And we are particularly of the southern kingdom of Israel, Judah. I will cause their captivity to return and have mercy on them. That's the history of the children, the sons and daughters of those that were taken in the slave trade of the Atlantic mid-crossing. That's our destiny. God bless you as you consider the truth behind Black History Month, because I just laid it down to you. In the name of Jesus Christ, Yahushua HaMashiach, so be it, O Lord.